Jeffrey Brown spoke to Margaret a short time ago.
Margaret, let me ask you first, how do Ukrainians and Western officials you're talking to explain what's going on with Vladimir Putin and his seemingly contradictory statements?
They believe, Jeff, that he's playing a double game. On the one hand, he does want to keep Ukraine destabilized and kind of torn between East and West. On the other hand, he doesn't want to be blamed entirely for being responsible for really messing up this election, because the U.S. and the Europeans have made it really clear to him that there will be tougher economic sanctions. And you noticed that his remarks today came at an economic forum of big global CEOs in St. Petersburg. So the intimidation campaign continues. He'd like to be make it look like, you know, the results are of dubious legitimacy. But I'm told he's been privately, or people close to him privately, already talking to the man who's considered to be the likely winner, if not outright on Sunday, then in a runoff. And that is the so-called chocolate king, this multi-billionaire Petrochenko.
Well, so then based on your reporting, if Putin does respect the outcome of the election, what would be the impact on the so-called Donetsk People's Republic?
Well, Jeff, I can only tell you, when we told people from the Donetsk People's Republic that Putin had said this week that he was going to be moving troops off the border, they really looked dismayed. This is not a hugely professional operation, either in a military sense or a governing sense. It does not compare to Crimea, where I was. And when you saw the Russians sort of trained and advised locals really taking control down there, it doesn't feel that way here. There are a lot of internal spats. They're having trouble even governing the areas they hold. And so the belief among Ukrainian officials here is, without Russia's backing, that it will be easier to clear them out. Now, they may be wrong. You heard Parabi say that, and they may be wrong, but that is the belief.
And finally, Margaret, I know that you are back in Kiev. What's the atmosphere like ahead of Sunday's election?
Kind of odd, Jeff. You know, there's no pre-election frenzy. I mean, you have seen billboards and so on. But today, Poroshenko refused to show up at a debate, and instead he was at the hotel where we are meeting with Norwegian and Danish officials. You get this feeling that everyone's looking ahead. And even one of the candidates I talked to, who comes from Yanukovych's party, you know, which used to be the most powerful party, he said, we've just got to get through this election. We've got to get a government that everyone recognizes, and so we can move forward. So the stakes are really high, but this does not feel like an American-style, you know, last-minute, last-evening rallies such as we would have in the States.
Margaret Warner in Ukraine for us. Thanks so much.
My pleasure, Jeff.